super spooky Halloween special, guys. And, and I call this a spooky Halloween special, even though it's not going to be that spooky, because we're doing a graveyard and a cathedral for this episode. And it's a special episode because it's not on a Monday. So, there's that.
Yep.
So,
I'm getting straight to work, and, yeah.
So am I. We're going to do a speed up for this, guys, because this is going to be a very lengthy build. And instead of watching us build for 2 hours straight, it'll only be like 20 minutes for you guys. So, you can thank me for that. So, we're going to speed up here, and we'll see you guys when we're done. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, we're back. And hope you enjoyed that speed up. Draku is our banner maker. He loves making banners.
Yay.
And here is the full frontal view of the cathedral.
Full frontal? Oh my.
And I added a little bit more to it. Because the top side.
Looks like a transformer from here.
Oh, you would say that. But anyway, we left some of the graveyards undone over here because we figured this graveyard won't be full yet. We're gonna be adding, you know, make it like more people could end up dying in the future. Because most graveyards are not completely full with graves. So this is unused spots, a couple prepared graves just waiting for people to kneel. This is going to be a build we do next time, as well as this one. That's going to be a Steveville memorial for all his people from his town that died. This is going to be a pet cemetery, as you can see with all the animal stuff. And these blocks don't actually have animal print on them in vanilla, but using this texture pack they do, and that's why we use them. And it just really seems to fit right. And then we're going to do a in real life mausoleum over there on that hill.
Wow.
Which I don't feel like walking all the way over there.
Yeah, this is a very expansive cemetery.
And then I use the iron door right here just because I like the look of it.
And plus, when we actually have a priest,
he'll stay trapped in here.
Yep.
Here's our pews with
fire! Brimstone! Ah!
Choir seats, his deacon chairs. Just fleshed it out. It looks like a church. It looks like a cathedral.
Fire! Yeah. Oh, fire, brimstone, bad. Go to hell.
This would be his office for counseling married couples, or people who have trouble.
Oh, I like the picture you picked.
Yeah. Just random. And then I used the oak doors because they were my second choice for the main door. Because I like the arch in it, kind of looks cathedral-ish. And then this would be the priest's bedroom. Just, you know, stuff he needs to live. Nothing major. Chest, craft table.
Bed.
Bed, yeah. The bare essentials he needs to live in. I love how high the roof is. I really wanted to make it that high up. Creeper is in the back turned out just right. Roll the banners.
Me personally, I think we probably should have put in at least a couple chandeliers.
Yeah, we might do that at a later date.
We'd probably wait until we get some glowstone.
Yeah. Speaking of which, I think that's something we're going to be doing very soon because the reason why all these torches are on the floor, even though I have torches up here, is the spots on the floor I wanted to put glowstone lamps. And then it hit me. I don't have glowstone dust to make the lamps with glowstone blocks in the plant. And that's a problem. We gotta go to the nether. But I want to put some lamps in the floor because the way they look is just really awesome. So I know I have torches up here. And I don't really need lamps, but I want it for decoration. Plus, it'll actually function to light it up even more. And I did a mirror of that design. It's a little bit higher, but that's because I had a door on my house. I think it's a little bit higher. Yeah, it's like one block.
Yeah, by one block, okay.
Yeah, close enough.
Higher by one block.
Close enough. I love it. Snuck out with you, you didn't have to click the button. lower button. No, that's why I didn't lower button, because the window here won't.
Well, even though this is Halloween, these jack-o'-lanterns aren't scary. They're creepy at best, and not in a scary way, but more in a is it trying to hit on me way.
More in a, oh god, run away, bad touch, bad touch.
I need an adult, I need an adult.
But yeah, we kind of, I'm proud of what we did, and
we have a very, very wide variety of tombstones.
And Dragoo has a list of names, both funny and real, and people from his village that he has to make signs for, but we chose not to do that right now because
it'd take a bunch of time. It'd take a lot of time.
It's just getting kind of late.
As I walk on people's graves.
Yeah, this one looks like all the way over here.
This right here, this is like the church had to pay for these people to get buried. They have names, but they're paupers. I guess the proper name is the homeless. And here are unmarked graves. They're marked, but there's no name.
Yep,
no one knows who the fuck they are or anything.
And these are also more like the cheap tablet type things that you can get for people that just go like on the ground that you see in a lot of grave sites.
Yeah, we got a lot of cheap people, and then we got some rather high priced stuff.
Some people who like to show off, and somebody was overcompensating up there.
Yep. Even got the torch of burning, ever burning torch.
On top, like, yeah.
Remember me. And if you do not get that reference, go watch Futurama.
But yeah, I'm fairly proud with the build, how it turned out.
Yeah.
And next episode we will be doing those two and the mausoleum over there just to finish us out, and then we'll be working on
farms.
The farms, because we still need to finish up the animal stuff and the carrots and potatoes. So.
Carrots, potatoes, and melons. Oh my.
Because we did a lot of exploration and I managed to find some melons finally. Took me forever, but I finally found some melons growing. So yeah, guys, I think
yeah, and if anybody's wondering, I did kill a creeper and finally, and it dropped a head. So I just used the recipe for duping the pattern to a blank banner, and that's what happens. Cha.
Yeah.
Only need one creeper head. Only need one of the dies to make the pattern. Once you make the pattern, you can just dupe the living snot out of it just as long as you have the pattern and a blank banner. For anyone that is curious how I was able to duplicate this so often.
Which is why we every banner that he ends up making, we keep a copy of it.
Yep.
So if we ever need to use it again for some reason, we can easily do the dupe thing.
Or somebody burns it off.
Yeah, this is a very nice build.
Yep, yep.
And let's just stand on the bridge and look at it. And we'll close out the episode there.
This is becoming quite expansive.
No, we're not even done yet. We've also done some terraforming. You guys will see that one from the bridge, too. We've been preparing for future episodes.
Oh, you want to tell them about what happened to poor Ralph, I think his name was?
What happened to Ralph?
The blacksmith.
Oh, that's Aaron. Yeah, his roof kind of burned down, so we had to replace it all with this.
And it wasn't the lava. We can't tell if it was between the lava or a lightning strike.
Yes, because right before we noticed it, we also had a Billy Bat thunderstorm in the game. And I was like, was it a lightning strike or was it the lava? Because it sat here forever without the lava catching on fire. So I was like, was it a random, you know, ember that caught it on fire, or was it
random fire tick? Well, it looks pretty good from over here. I mean, all I really see is the church.
I think they updated something at 1.8.
It's burning, but it won't. It went out.
Okay. Cause like, you know, crafting benches used to not catch on fire, so that's why we put them there. We swapped them out.
It'll look good from the city.
Oh wow.
It'll look good from the city. Look over here.
No, look from right here on the bridge. You can see the church from here.
Yeah, I was talking about the rest of the cemetery.
Oh wow. I'm just surprised I can see it because it's so tall.
Well, it's not too far off of being on par with the windmill.
Actually, it might be. I think it's a little bit taller than the windmill. Like at the very top of the crosses.
Maybe. It's definitely more massive.
Oh, from this hill over here, it just looks nice.
Yep.
I'm happy with that build. Things really, really come along. And you can see there, we've already prepared for future episodes over there as well. Got things fenced off for the farm. And we've got a special technique for farming now that's automated that we're going to explain to you guys when we do these.
Even though two of our workers are being lazy again.
Basically, Ralph has hired help.
Yeah, and I have to correct them. I'm sorry, boss.
It's okay. Hey. We'll figure out. We'll have to put in a third person.
What happened to? Oh, when I got rid of the grass, apparently it got rid of the fence. Cause this was supposed to be a gate right here.
Yeah, it'll be all right. Anyways, guys, that's gonna do it for this episode. End off with it looking at the tip of the cathedral over there.
Wait.
And we'll talk to you guys later.
Peace, guys.